Hello and welcome to all you Taurus people out there. This is your monthly horoscope for February of 2022. And it's a short video, not too long this time, because it's very simple, it's very clear, but it's so, so deep. It's Pluto all over the place again, I know. But this is the last phase. This is the last phase in February, and especially towards the end of the month, there is some sort of a transformation going on. And it includes you, because you are ruled by Venus. And Venus is direct now and touching Pluto again for the third and last time around the very end of February. I'm going to say you the exact date when that is gonna happen. Bear with me. I know you Taurians, you of all the signs, you have the most patience. Yes, it's actually the 2nd of March, but around the last couple of days, you could say the last week of February, you're gonna feel this the most. So it's a sort of a culmination, the last week of February, into a transformation, and for all of us, because Pluto is activated, which is the planet of transformation. It's the planet of dying and getting reborn again. It's the planet of empowerment versus control. You know, you decide what you're gonna do. I would suggest the first thing. And because if you want to do the negative thing of Pluto, which is manipulating the situation, which is doing things under the surface or letting other people walk all over you, you're gonna have the more negative side of Pluto. And but the positive side is standing in your power, having respect for others. But for you, it's in a very enjoyable part of your horoscope, because it's in the ninth house. The ninth house, so this transformation is happening for you in the ninth house. It's in Capricorn, a fellow earth sign. So of course, these are general horoscope. It could be for most Taurians, you know, on a collective level, it's super, super positive. But there are going to be some Taurians, yes, where it's going to be hard. I mean, depending on the personal horoscope. But in general, the ninth house is a house of travel. It's the house of studying. It's the house of publishing. It's the house of culture. It's the house of, you could say, religion, and the house of spirituality, your connection with the divine. And first and foremost, it's the house about your what you think about and how you see the world in front of you. And I've been talking about this a long time, and now you're acting on it, because at the end of the month, Mars is connecting with this Venus Pluto. When Mars connects with the Venus Pluto, it means that your different way of thinking now, you're acting on it. You know, it could be through studying, traveling, and all those things that I just mentioned, right? So this is pretty positive. And but again, it is Pluto, so it demands a letting go and a building up again, and also it demands a lot of awareness around the negative side, the shadow side of your thinking. So watch your thinking very well. Watch your thoughts. You know, when they're going negative, you don't have to turn them around immediately. Already the awareness that you're thinking negative is already the first step of transformation. You know, I'm not going to keep it longer than this. I mean, this is it. It's a huge month. It's a huge Plutonic month for everyone. And you've got Jupiter in the 11th house, Jupiter in Pisces in the 11th house. So the 11th house is the house of friends, of social activities. So you're going to be social as well. I would say enjoy it. Thank you so much for watching. Have a splendid month. Bye-bye.